बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। टुडे लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज कुरान। अकॉर्डिंग टू द वेरियस डिक्शनरीज एंड द रिलीजियस वेब पेजेस, कुरान इज द सेक्रेट बुक ऑफ इस्लाम। इट इज़ ए होली बुक आर द स्क्रिप्चर ऑफ मुस्लिम्स रिवील्ड टू द प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद इन अरबिक। इट इज़ द रिवलेशन फ्रॉम ऑलमाइटी अल्लाह, सो विच लेज डाउन द लॉज एंड कमांडमेंट्स, कोड्स ऑफ सोशल एंड मॉरल बिहेवियर ऑफ मुस्लिम्स, द फॉलोअर्स ऑफ इस्लाम। ऑल दीज स्टेटमेंट्स रेस्ट्रिक्ट द कुरान टू ए पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी एंड इट्स फॉलोअर्स। हाउ अनफॉर्चुनेट इट इज़। नो डाउट दैट इट इज़ रिवील्ड टू द पीपल ऑफ अरेबिया एंड रिवील्ड इन अरबिक लैंग्वेज, बट द फैक्ट इज इट इज़ रिवील्ड टू द ऑल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स ऑफ द अर्थ। इट इज़ नॉट रेस्ट्रिक्टेड टू ए पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी अलोन, इट इज़ फॉर एवरी वन। द अर्लियर बुक्स नॉट ओनली इंक्लूड द साम्स, तोरा एंड बाइबल, दे आर मैनी मोर बुक्स रिवील्ड टू द अदर प्रोफेट्स, बट वी डो नॉट हैव द कम्प्लीट नॉलेज ऑफ इट। ऑल दीज बुक्स द साम्स, तोरा एंड बाइबल आर ऑल्सो रिवील्ड बाई द ऑलमाइटी अल्लाह सुभान व तआला टू द पीपल ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम। पीपल कंटेंडेड देमसेल्फ टू अ पर्टिकुलर रिवलेशन एंड डिड नॉट फॉलो द लेटर रिवलेशंस। Instead, they started segregating themselves as one separate religion and started opposing the new revelations and its followers. Later, the people went to such an extent that they started identifying the followers of these four books as the followers of Abrahamic religion. Then, who are the other people who follow other religions? They are also created by the Almighty Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the lone creator of this universe. Then, how can they call themselves they are different than the followers of Abrahamic religion? There is no division like Abrahamic religion and non-Abrahamic religion as such. They are also created by the same creator, as there is only one creator, that is Allah. And the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed the scriptures to them as well, but they fail to recognize and admit it. Now, let us understand what these books are all about. As per the existing knowledge, each book is a holy book of a particular religion. These books give guidance in the present life for the life to come in Jannah. All these books are having the same basic concept, but people are failed to understand this or do not want to accept this reality, as they consider their religion is superior to the other. How disheartening it is. There are no multiple religions exist in the world. There are no religions such as Christianity, Judaism, Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, Taoism, Confucianism, Shintoism, Zoroastrianism, etc. Since the beginning, only one religion exists in the world, that is Islam. And the one who submits to Allah is a Muslim, and the others are Kafirs. The Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent many prophets at different times to different nations, as he mentioned in Surah number 13, Ar-Ra'd, verse number 30, I quote, "And so we have sent you, O Prophet, to a community like we did with earlier communities, so that you may recite to them what we have revealed to you. Yet they deny the most compassionate. Say, He is my Lord. There is no God worthy of worship except Him. In Him I put my trust, and to him I turn in repentance," unquote. The Prophet Muhammad said there are approximately 1,24,000 prophets in total. Out of these 1,24,000, only 25 are mentioned in Quran. In addition to these 25, few more names of prophets are mentioned in Bible and Torah, to whom we all are familiar with. With the knowledge bestowed on me by the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, today I recognize few more and reintroduce them to the world with their true identity, inshallah. Following are the prophets appointed by the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sent to the people of Bharat, so which is a tribe like Samud and Ad. The prophets are Hanuman, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, Kartikeya, Ganesha, Rama, Krishna, Balarama, Parashurama, Valmiki, Mahavir, and Buddha, peace be upon them. Some of them are already mentioned in the Quran, but unfortunately we fail to recognize them. The Hanuman is none other than the Adam mentioned in the Quran, and Dhulkifl, the one with a fold, is none other than the Rama, and Dhulkarnain, the two-horned one, is none other than the Vishnu, to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned him as a just ruler. Now, let us come to the main point. What is Quran is all about? There is no doubt that the Quran is a religious holy book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which gives guidance to lead a pious life as per the laws laid down by the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a guidance towards the life to come after Qiyamah, as mentioned in Surah number 3, Al Imran, verse number 3 and 4, and I quote, "He has revealed to you, O Prophet, the book in truth, confirming what came before it, as he revealed the Torah and the Gospel previously as a guide for people, and also revealed the standard to distinguish between right and wrong. Surely, those reject Allah's revelations will suffer a severe torment, for Allah is Almighty, capable of punishment," unquote. Other than this, the Quran explains about the creation of the universe in general and the earth in particular. Allah says in Surah number 13, Ar-Ra'd, verse number 39, I quote, "Allah illuminates and confirms what He wills, and with Him is the Mother Book," unquote. That means to say, detailed information is mentioned in a mother book, which is called as Umm al-Kitab, and what is mentioned in Quran is a synopsis of that book, a QR code of the mother book. Now, let us understand what is a QR code. A QR code is an abbreviated form of quick response. A QR code is a type of matrix barcode, so which stores a lot of information, and on scanning using an optical image sensor, it delivers the information instantly. It may contain an URL which on opening provides detailed information of that product or service. Similarly, the Quran is a quick response book which stores a lot of major information on the creation of the universe and the earth, and the detailed information is stored in the Umm al-Kitab. Therefore, beyond doubt, the Quran is a QR code. Allahu Akbar. In some countries, few people pronounce Quran as Quran, that starts with the letter K, which is wrong. It cannot be Quran. It should be Quran, that starts with the letter Q, as it represents QR code in its true sense. I request everyone to be more specific in the pronunciation of Quran. Similarly, the other scriptures like Purana, Zabur or the Psalms, Taurat or Torah, and Injil or Bible are also the codes like PR, ZVR, TR and INGL respectively. I will talk about them in my future lectures, inshallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.